Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the main stage. Well, the only stage in the fan zone. Please give a huge round of applause, Mr. Alex Mullet. We could chant going, Alex, man, but we're not. We've got 5 minutes. He's a red. You want to pass it on?
Cause Alex Mullet, he's a red. Oops.
Alex, first of all, you want to just pass the mic on? I know you like to talk, but yeah. Alex, first of all, disappointed, obviously, not involved today. Can you give us any update whatsoever about the injury?
I done it last Friday in training. Probably shouldn't have played in the game at Chef Wednesday, but I did, and hopefully I'll be back soon. I don't think it'll be too long.
What have you made of it so far? You played a key role, obviously, last season in the promotion season. Lots of players, well, a few players left, lots of new players coming in. What are you doing to help them settle in?
Just trying to help them with the way the gaffer wants to play, you know. The gaffer's a bit crazy, so when he's explaining it, it's a bit different, so I try and tell him in English.
He says to the Dutchman. What's it been like? Because we've all talked about that win, obviously, here against Fulham, and suddenly expectations were on the roof. So 3-5, if we finish fourth from bottom, that'll be fine for me. We'll be at Fulham saying, that's it, Premier League next season. As a player, are you sort of, because obviously a fantastic performance, you need to stay grounded, or don't you? Because that was one of many games in this league.
We were the same, to be fair. It was like, oh, it's easy, this. I think the Chef Wednesday game, it was bit back to reality, and that's how the game is going to be tough in the Championship, but at Oakwell, hopefully we can win most of our games here.
And the last thing about today's game, Charlton obviously promoted with us. A lot of people say, oh, you know, we must win these, an unbeaten record at home, but they've not had a bad start at all, have they, against Blackburn away and Stoke at home, two victories.
Yeah, they've started well, but hopefully they're back here now, and we can do what we've done to them last season.
Right, so to get to know Alex Mullet a bit more, because we know how he plays, we know what he looks like, we know he likes his flat caps. In true Reds Report style, we've got 6 really quick-fire questions. You have to excuse us. There's a group chat, and at 3 o'clock this morning, we're still thinking of questions. So the first to do is from me, Alex. And that is, Bear Grylls invites you and a teammate to camp deep in the jungle for a week. You have to look after yourself, and he's only there for information. Which teammate would you take in the jungle, and why? If you can't think of it, tell us who you wouldn't want to take in the jungle, because that's just as good.
Definitely not Corley Woodrow.
And why is that, Alex?
Because he just panics about everything, so it'd be no good. I'd have to say Kenny Dougal.
Kenny Dougal? Yeah. Is he a bit handy, like?
Yeah, he knows his stuff.
Right, and the second one. We've beaten Leeds at home on a Sunday in front of the Sky cameras, and Daniel Stendhal sends a group text out saying, party at my place tonight, it's fancy dress. What are you going as why?
Probably like Shrek or something.
Right, Kyle, your questions.
So Daniel Stendhal's a fan of high tempo and high pressing. Are you the same when it comes to household chores?
Oh, that's all sure.
Yeah, you're
good
at rushing.
Cooking, cleaning.
Oh, no.
Leave it to Mrs.
No, I got a cleaner.
So we saw a clip of this week of Daniel Stendhal riding his bike to Oakwell. So if you had the choice, what car or supercar would be in your garage and why?
I'd say Lamborghini. Just because it's a Lamborghini.
Just because it's a Lamborghini. Cheers, Alex.
Cheers, mate.
So Alex, obviously, you're at Barnsley now. Previously, you've had spells at Leeds, and you're a Doncaster lad as well, so you've seen a bit of Yorkshire. Why is Barnsley better at everything? Just what's good about Barnsley? What makes it the best?
The accent's just funny, isn't it? So.
All right, pal. One more question for you, Alex. Obviously, there's a lot of players have come in this summer, and I understand there's some kind of, you know, initiation, you know, you all have a good sing song. You've heard a few of players sing. So who what best? With what song? And who were the worst?
The worst was one of the staff. He was just mumbling and stuttering, and he went bright red, so he was shocking. And the best was probably Toby. Toby was decent.
Yeah, what did he sing?
Can't remember.
So good night then.
Yeah, good.
Before we thank Alex Mowitz. Just a quick reminder that Dern FM journalist Joe Beattle lost his granddad, and he's asking for an 85-minute applause. If you can join in with that, that would be absolutely fantastic. And just as a last question, we'll probably know the answer. What game are you looking forward to most this season, and why?
Yeah, definitely the Leeds game. I don't know whether the Leeds game here or the Leeds game away. We'll have to see where we both are on the table at the away game, but definitely the Leeds game here.
Absolutely fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, huge round of applause, Alex Mowitz.
We're joined by Lucy outside Oakwell today. Lucy, it's been a tough week for a Barnsley fan. Should we be hitting the panic button?
I think it's a bit early in the season, to be honest, Chris, to hit panic button. You know, you look back to Tuesday and it weren't brilliant football.
Certainly wasn't, no.
It still is early days, and you know, we've got quite a new squad, and they still need time to gel, I think.
So, have you seen enough from the Fulham game to believe that we're more than capable of staying in this division?
We were pretty good against Fulham.
Yep.
You know, I think Fulham expected to come and beat us, being promotion favourites to back into Premiership. But we took our chances and we beat them. Again, it's still a bit early, but I think, you know, I think we'll be pretty safe this season.
Can we reproduce that form and performance today?
I'm hoping we can. You know, Charlton are looking quite strong this season, and we already know a bit about Charlton from last season. Obviously, we came up with them. But hopefully, we can get a winning bag.
Yes, so today's prediction from yourself?
I'm going to go 2-1 Reds.
2-1 first goal scorer?
Ooh. I think Woodrow might get it.
Woodrow, who might get second one?
Chaplin.
So a Reds win, 2-1. Yeah. Woodrow Chaplin.
Yes.
Spot on, you'll do for me, obviously. We'll take that.
Thanks very much, Dave. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Barnsley FC Fan Zone. Afternoon, everyone. Oh, they're half awake. The Reds report. Myself, Carl Walker, Chris Ridyard. We're on the radio every Thursday afternoon, live at Vibe, on a stadium called The Vibe. If you got one of them irritating Alexa things, ask it, Alexa, please play The Vibe Barnsley. And you can see faces for radio. This is what we do. Very special guest with us today, because we're sort of like armchair supporters, us, so we thought we'll bring somebody in who's played a bit of football. Can I have a huge round of applause for Mr. Adi Moses? So, first of all then, Chris, start with you. Fantastic start to the season, Fulham. Can I say a masterclass, player of the pitch, 1-0. Couldn't repeat that performance at Sheffield Wednesday, and I think some of the fans sort of, you know, felt it a bit more than maybe what they should. You know, it's early in the season, and then we had that match that we like to forget about, which was the one against Carlisle on Tuesday. So how important is it today for the Reds to come out fighting and repeat that performance against Fulham, against a side that was promoted with us?
Yeah, today is quite an important day as a Barnsley fan, isn't it? I think it's very early on in the season. I think it's far too early to be pressing the big red panic button, so to speak. Obviously, the performance against Fulham was, impeccable. You know, we were faultless, weren't we? I mean, if you'd have swapped those two round and we'd have got beat by Fulham and beat Sheffield Wednesday, and we'd have beat Sheffield Wednesday, would we have been panicking as much? Possibly not, really. I think we probably got spoiled here, you know, 2 weeks ago, and it's still early days. It's a young team. There's a lot of building needs to be done. Do you agree, Kyle?
Yeah, I think, like we said, we can't really press that panic button too early on. Like we said, we've had two games in League, one in Cup. Cup game didn't really quite come off, but it were six new players coming in that starting 11, and, you know, it's just time for them to gel and work better. Anybody but Sheffield Wednesday, I think we would have not been complaining as much, but it's because it's them. And like we said, we've seen what we're capable of against Fulham, so don't press that panic button, and today's a good day to get back on track.
Adi, to you then, as an ex-player, Daniel Stendhal said before Tuesday's match against Carlisle, he wanted to see a reaction from the players following that defeat at Hillsborough. But then he made quite a few changes. So as a player coming in and making your full debut, is that extra pressure, your manager asking for a reaction in a match that you weren't involved in?
Not really. I don't think so. I think if I ever played and we had a bad result, I think we had the manager saying that. Everybody knows what it means to the fans. And a couple of times I've been on wrong defeats here, big scorelines and that. And you just, personally, it's your own pride as well. You're just naturally up for the next game anyway. If the manager then, you know, is like a, you know, bear with sore head kind of thing all week, it's one of them. I mean, Danny Wilson were he'd be renowned for it. Some, you know, he could have face on with us all week. We got beat on Saturday. All week, you could tell he were in a mood. Eric Winstanley were exactly the same, but we had that front youth team where you didn't want to upset Eric. And all week, they were like that. Come Friday morning, Danny would come out with a different person and we're bubbly. Say, we're up for this tomorrow. I can see we're going to get a reaction like that. And you just did, and that's what you did, really. So I think, personal point of view, whoever's in team, at this stage of the season, they're all chomping at a bit. They all want that shirt. It shouldn't be a case that Stendhal has to have a go at them to get a reaction. Naturally, you should be just up for that next game. And after Tuesday night, I mean, this is the first time I've been this season. That's in 8 games. The boys come, first game of the season, said it were absolutely fantastic. So I've been a little bit surprised. Not so much with Wednesdays, because we never go and win at Wednesdays. I never won at Wednesdays when I played for them either. But the Carlisle game was such a surprise. Yeah, there is changes in there. But whoever were involved at Wednesdays, I would expect a reaction today anyway, regardless of Stendhal getting into them. Because you just know, coming out on there, the fans are going to demand it. And I would just expect them to be like the Fulham game and just be right up for it and right at it from start today.
You played, to me personally, some of your best football, obviously, at Barnsley. You now come back as a fan. Do I take it that every ball you're setting at a stand and you're still going left, right? Are you still sort of involved, or is it easier to sort of sit back and you just let the play?
It is easier. Obviously, I had really good times here at Barnes. It might seem quite a long time ago, but when I sit up there, I bring my boys, who are season ticket holders. They love it, and I just come back as a dad, where I can spend time with my boys and kind of relax. I think a lot of fans still come and speak to me. And they really, and that's great. I love that, the fact that, you know, they still remember those times, and obviously there were successful times with his premiership and all that. But I can kind of relax a little bit, and I think a few fans leave us alone and think he's there with his kids. I've got time for anybody, me, and if they want to come and chat to me, I do. But the only thing is, then I'll go up and watch it, and I'm sitting top at East End. I still think I can do it, and I forget that I'm like mid-40s getting on now, and it just looks so easy from there. You see all the space on the pitch and you are thinking, why has he done that? Is it? And I don't just mean that as an ex-player, it's just that it looks so simple up there, and that's what you're going to forget. And then the only time is then when they do come out, it's still that same music that they come out to, and I just still get airs up back in my next stand-up at that point, and that's when I still think I'd love a game today. I'd love to be out there, like, so...
You talk about the glory days, you talk about the music. Obviously, Barnsley FC has gone through a huge transformation with, very rich owners coming in and consortium and taking over. How relieved are you as an ex-player and a fan that we have things like this, a fan zone? The music's not changed, the players are still that approachable. So we kept that sort of community feel about the club. How important is that?
It's massive. It's one of the reasons why I enjoyed my most successful times in my career here at Barnsley, and I think one of the reasons for that were it was at that time, which is very similar now, it was such a coming together at that time of all everything just knitted perfectly, and it was such a homely club, a family club. You know, you'd finish training and then you'd go and have a chat with Rimmo, you'd have a chat with Mags, the tea lady, she'd tell you what you were doing wrong on Saturday, you'd have a cup of tea after training, and there were just that, you know, kit man, Roy, groundsman, it was just so, everything was so tight knit and such a homely family club, and it was that was what built us really, and it was that importance that we just managed to, it was a crest of a wave. I mean, obviously Danny being in charge and the staff that were already here, that were great, kids that were coming through, signings that we made, but it were that togetherness that we had as a club, and I do still think it is very similar now, and I could see that last year. We, you know, manager interacts with fans, you can tell that they've got a good relationship, all the staff, that together. And I think when you've got sections where they're not with them and they're not with them, that's when it all starts a bit. And Barnsley, for me, when I went on to my other clubs, it were never quite like that. And it probably didn't, towards the end of my career here, you know, the Bassett era and stuff like that, it weren't quite what it were then. And I think that were key to what we did at that time with the promotion and all that. But It is such a big thing, and if you've got that togetherness at the club, which we had, and I think they've got it now, it'll take you a long way.
Chris and Kyle, latest information that we have is that Alex Mowat is injured and probably won't take part today. As a fellow Doncaster lad, how much of a miss is there? Because he was one of our key players last season, wasn't he? You know, he signed, I think he got a stray red, didn't he, on his debut. He was loaned out to Oxford. We sort of forgot about him, in fairness. Still, Daniel Stendhal came in, one of the key players last season. How big of a miss is that for the Reds this afternoon?
Yeah, it's been a key, integral part. Like I say, since he come back from that spell at Oxford, I mean, obviously he's come with a lot of big expectation coming from a club like Leeds, and then it didn't quite work out start. But then, to be fair to him, he's come back from that, kicked on and had a fantastic year last year. I really like his style of play. He looks so comfortable on ball, you know, his lovely left foot just keeps things ticking over there, never gets flustered and that, and he's been a big part of that. But like I said before, him going out is somebody else's opportunity, and that's where somebody else has got to be chomping a bit to get in there and think, right, this is my chance. And that's what you need. You want you want people coming in, and when Alex is fit again, he's thinking, I've got to put a shift in to get that shirt back. And that competition for places is what breeds, you know, that competition for good results, things like that, because everybody's wanting that shirt and everybody's giving it 100% and doing the best.
Yeah. Chris, first match of the season, Michael Stephen Bearer was the captain. He was then taken off at Hillsborough, substituted. Who do you expect to fill that Alex Mowat role? Do you think Bearer will maybe play a little bit deeper, or what's your expectations of the lineup today?
Yeah, I think having come Tuesday night for the League Cup, and I saw a different midfield, middle two, so to speak. I'm not convinced that Stiles is the man for the job just yet. I think he's still developing. I think he's still learning the Stendal way. So to me, I think you might see Michael Stephen Bearer probably play a little bit deeper today. As for who's going to then join Corley Woodrow up top, do you play Wilkes and do you play Mamadou Tiamont wing? I don't know, that's the question, is it? And I'm not the Barnsley manager, so luckily I don't have to make that decision today.
Well, I tell you what, Kyle, if you take the microphone, I've got the Barnsley lineup for you this afternoon. In goal, number one, Redlinger. Number three, Ben Williams. Number five, Bambo Diaby. Number six, Mats Anderson. Number eight, Cameron McGeehan. Number nine, Corley Woodrow. Number 10, Mike Stephen Bearer. Number 11, Connor Chaplin. And then we've got Luke Thomas at 16. Number 21, Toby Sibbick. And completing the lineup this afternoon for the Reds at number 36 is Malik Wilkes. Right, Chris, for you then. The substitute bench looks as follows this afternoon. Brett Collins, Jordan Williams, Dimitri Kavare, Patrick Schmidt, Callum Stiles, Apo Halme and Mamadou Thiam. Just a quick word on Jordan Williams. Played well. Bit of a if and when player last season, but never really let us down. He got his chance on Tuesday against Carlisle. Result aside, thought he played a decent match. And how important is it to have that competition for places? So just because you played really well on a Tuesday night at Oakwell doesn't necessarily guarantee you a starting position on the Saturday match against Charlton.
Yeah, I think that's incredibly important as a footballer. I mean, I'm sure Eddie can shed more light on it after myself. But I know that competition for places, and you're always looking over your shoulder. I think if you're playing every week and there's no competition for your position, I don't know, you could argue you may become complacent and probably a bit lackadaisical. Would you agree with that, Eddie?
Yeah, exactly what I said before. Like I said about Alex, you know, if he's at the team, he's expecting somebody's going to come in and try and take his shirt and keep hold of his shirt. And, you know, if they're doing it, it's hard sometimes to get back in. But that's what the squad did, and they made a lot of signings in summer. So that's what you want. You want that competition. You want everybody, fighting for that first 11.
To put you on the spot, AD, and ask you for a score forecast for today, what do you think the result will be?
Yeah, I think there'll be a reaction from last week, and I think Barnsley win 2-1.
Oh, I like it. Chris, go on.
1-0, Mads Anderson, 90th minute.
He's been saying that all season, and he'll probably continue to say that all season. Kyle, what do you reckon? Can I just put a stat out there? Charlton have played two matches in the league so far. They've had six shots at goal, and they've scored five. That's something we need to be wary of, isn't it?
Yeah, we definitely need to be wary of that, because any sniff of chance, they look like they put it away. So I'm going, I think there'll be goals, and I'll go with 3-2 to Barnsley. I think we will bounce back today.
Right, just to complete the lineup, we've got the opposition lineup as well, so I'll just go around because I know you were very interested. For Charlton lining up, Dylan Phillips, Jason Pearce as captain, Lyle Taylor, who we know very well, Ben Puddington, Darren Pratley, Chris Solly, Johnny Williams, Josh Cullen, Tom Lockyer, Conor Gallagher, and Jonathan Leeko. Does that surprise you with all the lineup? Because we talked about some of the danger men in Thursday's show.
No, I don't think it surprised me as it stands. I mean, middle of the park for Charlton's pretty much what you'd expect, with Solly on wing and Williams in middle. I think the key battle there is Williams. If he gets the room in the midfield and McGeehan's not watching him, I think he's got the key to unlock us, as Johnny Williams, a very clever player. So I think we'll be all right. I'm not too worried.
Very good. Can I just have a final then before we're back on stage later on with non-playing player? Can you please show your appreciation to Eddie Moses?
Thank you, Eddie.